the looks of society, and for many, you are what you wear. Are you what you wear? For some reason, to some people, they are what they wear. Over the weekend, Kemi Akande chatted with Lagos socialite on his habits of fashion and lifestyle. That you get to see on the Spotlight segment after this break. And do remember, we have loads of interesting segments on Fashionista, like the Fashion and Beauty Corner, Update Me segment, and of course, the Model's Diary. We'll go on a quick break and return just in a moment. Welcome back, and if you're just tuning in, the program is called Fashionista, and I'm your humble host, The Avenues. It was a cool and fun-filled photo shoot over the weekend with Lagos socialite Mr. Noble Igwe of Three Sister Degrees Nubs at the Chrome Bar in Victoria Island, Lagos. Check it out.
Welcome to another scintillating episode of Spotlight. We're here at Chrome Bar and Nightclub in the heart of Victoria Island, Lagos, to interview none other than Lagos socialite Noble Igwe. Join me and let's find out what his personal style is and what the latest trends he's following. Okay, so Noble, tell us, what are your favorite designers at the moment in Africa?
Well, in Africa, I would say De La Sego. If you talk about like the most favorite, right?
Yeah,
I love De La Sego. I wear De La Sego, I wear Emi Collins, I wear Maya Tapo, I wear David Bola. These are Nigerian designers, yeah. Basically, I would say my favorite is De La Sego.
We see you a lot with your red trousers. I have to bring that up. It seems like it's your favorite, you know, your favorite must-have item. When did this love affair begin?
Well, like, you know, there's a whole lot of things about people who are not so tall. Like, I'm not a very tall young man, but I have also made it a point of duty that whenever I step into a place, I have to make a statement, or probably can't just ignore me.
So yeah.
The red trousers is, I mean, there's no book of fashion that says you mustn't wear red trousers or any other thing, but that's because people have followed the backlash trend by people who they think they should respect and get fashion rules. But I mean, there's fashion, there's style. My style is to follow what I think fits me at any point in time and not to follow what other people are doing. But the red trouser is here to stay for a bit.
Tell us a bit about your background. We know that you started at Virgin and then you moved to 141 Advertising. What kind of business endeavors are you into at the moment?
Well, I started at Virgin in 2005. I started from the call center. Then from the call center, I moved to the marketing department. I started the first ever Virgin Nigeria Investment Sponsorship Department. Then I worked at Virgin from 2005 to 2008. I left Virgin Nigeria for 141 Worldwide because I wanted to understand the concept of starting a business. I wanted to understand the concept of promoting a business, what it takes to sell a product to the public. So I worked at 141 between 2008 and 2010, and I left only 2011 to focus on my own business.
What celebrity friends do you have?
My closest friends are Ebuka Obichendo. A lot of people know him from when he was in Big Brother. Alain Olamide is a manager. Olamide Adedeji is a manager at Sound City. Segun Demore sits at top of a lot of other companies, especially as well as EME, the record label that hosts Whiskey and Banky W. But I mean, apart from those are my closest friends and everything. Then after those three people, then other people, like every other person, like Dibanj, Danjazi, MI. I don't know, like, you know what I mean? Names, like okay. It's going to be like an entire roll call. Yeah.
Now we know why he loves red trousers, and we know his favorite celebrity friends are Banky W, Ebuka, and MI. Now he loves rocking Emi Collins and Amaya Tafu. Let's find out what else he loves. Well, let us know your five favorite jeans for men.
Well, I'm one of those people who you would say don't kind of have like a favorite when it comes to. I can't say these are the favorite jeans I wear. I, like I told you earlier, whatever fits, wear it. Like I have a De La Sego I have a DLC Go limited edition baggy jeans.
Okay.
I think she made like about 10 of it. I even have to put that out. Yes, I have like one of the 10.
Yeah.
Oh, I have a DLC Go skinny jeans.
Okay.
And I have a DLC Go boot cut jeans. So,
You really like those?
I like the cold. Yeah. Then I love Rock and Republic. Okay. I have news of Rock and Republic. And the normal Levi's still is one of the maybe you can really tell you. I like the cut Zara jeans as well. So I might not be big on trying to name like the big label. I'm more or less interested in what fits. So I might not say go out there, but whatever you do here in Nigeria, okay, just a good jean. I mean, if you want to wear something foreign, probably Rock and Republic can maybe get more of those and wear as well. Then I mean Zara is for people who probably like I keep saying Zara make clothes for slim people, or like so I mean get something like that European fits you, sits in your waist, then that's long enough, not food or whatever, basically.
Okay. Noble, it's been lovely talking to you. We found out what your personal style is, the celebrities that you like that are fashionable, and the designers that you endorse.
Thank you very much. It's been great
having a Spotlight segment.
Thank you very much.
So thanks for tuning in, guys. We'll see you next time on Spotlight.
Noble Igwe always on point. I'm loving his royal blue jacket that he rocked on the photo shoot. It was real cool and it works for him. Well, for those of you out there who missed the dream wedding of the century that took place at a prestigious incubator here in Victoria Island, Lagos really means the special moment of the glitz and glamour of what a dream wedding should be like, and how the man of the moment, who pays attention to details, Mr. Bai Atafo, pulled off a flamboyant event. Did you miss the dream wedding? If you did, you can as well witness it here on Fashionista. Happy viewing.
Good afternoon, darling. Can I know you?
My name is Zoe Chinaka.
How did it take you to dress?
It didn't take me like so much. It just took me like less than an hour. I was done. Okay, I thought, okay, it's a wedding theme, so I'm gonna go all white, a bit all white, and then I thought I wanted to look simple and Grecian as well, so yes, that's the whole look.
I have a wedding show, and so I have a thing for weddings, and basically, for me, I love to follow the trend when it comes to weddings, from the dress, to the outfit, to the wall, to every single little detail, and so I think there's been a great improvement. There's been a great growth between the weddings of yesterday and today, and it's just evolving, it's just changing. Now people infuse their personality, their color and everything into their weddings, and so
I think it's not just all about the wedding dresses, from the venue to the person who made the cake, to the person who made the headpieces, to the person who, you know, put the whole event together, because I'm part of the sponsor. I made most of the fascinators and the headpieces, and I think it's really a good idea what he came up with, you know, open way for people to know him more and know his dresses more.
With that in mind, I would like to introduce the bride and groom.
Alex Akubo is the Nigeria first runner-up. Mai always knows how to push the limits, you know. Mai knows how to cut the right, make the right cuts, make the right turn. I think every time I put on the mic, Couture, your whole body kind of like feels like, you know you're in something very classy. Mai is a very classy designer, very edgy, knows what it's doing, knows where it's going, knows how to get it.
In Nigeria?
I don't have a favorite designer because I've worked with so many of them and they're fantastic, they're good, I'm very creative, and Mai is one of the people that I've worked with for such a long time, so I think they're all amazing. My name is Amomi Akinifasi, most beautiful girl in Nigeria 2005, and you're watching Fashionista.
Definitely put yourself in a league of your own.
This is it's a beautiful collection and it's quite creative.
Like, people are out there to emulate you and copy you because there's no other Mai in Nigeria. So I'm more than proud to be one of his models on the show today.
I like what he's done with the whole collection and the whole show in general. And I think that it's a breath of fresh air for wedding planning and, you know, wedding gowns and groom outfits of any kind that if you want your dream wedding to look like, you can always call Mai. He'll hook you up. That's it.
Thank you so much. Now you may kiss the bride.
Yeah, we're not doing it again for you.
Hello, my name is Mona, and you are watching Fashionista.
Fashionista? Yeah, Fashionista. Don't touch that dial.
Makita, the face of Slick 2009. How are you, Makita?
I'm good. I'm very good. I'm very excited because I get to be a bride before I'm actually a bride. So it's really cool. It's awesome. The dresses are amazing. there's lace and satin and silk. It's just awesome. And the bridesmaid clothes dresses are really nice as well. Hi, my name is Makeda Mokka, face of Sleek Nigeria 2009, and you're watching Fashionista.
I'm Larida Silva Ajayi. It's amazing. It's cool because Nigeria is beginning to be like really fashion forward. You have to agree with me. And doing this is cool because that means you go to him and you already know that there's something that samples on ground. Fantastic idea.
My name is Larida Silva Ajayi. I'm watching Fashionista.
We targeted the dream wedding just for the sheer fact that it is a dream wedding. I mean, how many weddings do you get decorated this beautiful? How many weddings do you get cakes designed after the wedding gowns? You know, how many weddings do you get, you know, someone take off the wedding gown and leave another one? You know, how many weddings do you get Wajid to come and sing for you, or Bears, or Chidimma, or, you know, Yemi Alade, or Praise? You know, you don't get that in normal weddings. So this is actually a dream wedding. So it's like you see all these things in one day under one roof for one wedding. You had like six different kind of cakes here today. You know, you had canapés, you had cocktails. It was absolutely amazing. So that's why it's a dream wedding. My name is Maya Tafo. I'm a fashion artist, and you are watching Fashionista.
That was indeed a dream wedding. I kind of like the part of Prince Uti and Princess Mona. Well, from Fashionista, we wish them happy married dream wedding. Up next is the update in the segment, Sweet BB, Kemi, and Prince.
Welcome, viewers. This is another episode of Update Me on Fashionista. I'm Bibi Udo, a fashion stylist, and with me is
Kemi Kande, fashion and business consultant.
Prince Uzebo, catwalk instructor, choreographer.
We're here to tell you what's in and what's not this season. Kemi, what do you think is in and what's not?
Well, I think bright colors are really in this season, especially for men. We're seeing a lot of catwalks and a lot of entertainers embracing bright colors, whether it's bright skinny jeans or bright tees.
Like we have here.
Ah, Prince.
Someone here is wearing purple and
don't you like
yellow.
It?
Okay, well, as you can see from this clip, this is a like Prince style, very over the top, using a lot of different colors here. I'm not sure it really works.
No, it doesn't, because everything is rainbow. There's green, there's red, there's blue, there's dark blue, there's red, there's yellow. Everything is not working.
I love this. This is so good. Come on, he's playful, he's having fun, he's
Are you
young.
For real? Like, seriously?
I mean, this is like color blindness.
Excuse
like,
me,
I'll need like some sunglasses
edgy.
To help
edgy.
Me.
I love this. This is so
You know,
sweet,
I'll honey. Literally go sweet. Blind if I see this person on the road. Like,
why?
This is hideous.
It's too much. But you know what? There's a lot of young people that are wearing these type of fashion trends now. You walk into the mall and you see loads of kids wearing these bold colors from head to toe, and I really think it's a bit too much. It's very youthful. Mm-hmm. I don't think anyone should rock this style
no,
at the age of 21.
It's too much.
I don't want to see it.
Okay, let's see Ebuka. Ebuka is wearing a pink shirt on the black pants, but the suspenders.
Oh my dear.
They're not working for
it's
him.
It's making like, me
oh
laugh.
They're not
dear.
Working
no,
for him. But pink is a major color this season,
yeah,
and
it
I
is.
Foresee it sticking around for quite a long time. I love the bright pink shirt. I think it really works.
I don't like it. It screams tacky,
Why?
Tacky, tacky.
No, with the suspenders on, it's tacky, but without it, he's totally
be
rocking
fine.
It because he's on black pants and black shoes, and no, the suspenders is
He's
so
a really stucky, I don't
still.
Like him.
Prince, he's a reality TV
like
star. He
so,
wants to stand
right, I don't
out.
Like it.
He's been
I don't
on
like
Big
this
Brother.
Tacky,
he's on
no,
Red Carpet.
Ebuka can do better. He can do better,
of course,
actually.
He can.
Let's
he can
see
do
somebody
better.
Else rocking the pink.
Okay,
Kanye West. That's lovely.
Let's see. I love
you know,
I love
in a white
I
shirt.
So much.
And gray pants and white. You know, it's subtle, and yet he's wearing a bright color. And he's totally walking and rocking. He's rocking it.
I think
he's
I love
totally
this.
Rocking.
I love
this.
This
is beautiful.
I love this.
It's beautiful. And see again.
Whoa.
Again, the blazer. That's another
oh
style
gosh.
Trend that's in. Bright
it's
blazers.
Beautiful.
And
really beautiful.
Juxtapose those with
and he still made it
white. White pants. Like white pants. Seriously,
yeah.
I love that.
He still made it subtle
so
with
good.
Black shoes.
So
yeah, he didn't like go and wear
yeah.
red shoes or something.
I think this is
again.
Where definitely getting your colors right. Move on.
Whoa,
okay.
Red
okay.
pants.
Red skinny jeans. I love it. It's been in for a while. This this keeps coming in and out, actually, of the catwalks. Girls rock it, men rock it. I think it's something that's definitely here
you
to
know
stay.
Something about colorful pants? when you want to make a pan colorful, just wear a neutral up and neutral down. That way you rock it. But the one with the leopard skin is not working.
My dear, it's called drama. It's not called drama.
Kanye West overdoes it sometimes, we know that. No, but as we can compare the two, which one would you prefer out of those two?
Of course, the white and the red. Amaran is better. It always brings a balance to any colorful pants. Gray always does the magic, so always do something with your gray to bring everything down so you don't have to look like a masquerade.
I think the best places to like that are really pushing these trends are, you know, online shopping like ASOS, Top Man, they do a lot of this kind of styles. Yeah. So if people want to really perpetuate these kind of fashions, look to the high street. I think they're all there. So we've told you what not to wear and what you should be rocking this season. Good luck, guys.
Thanks for watching. Bye. We'll see you next time. Bye.
Here is the front porch of opportunities where corrections are taken serious on fashion faux pas. The model industry in Nigeria has experienced an unprecedented boom. But even as all this is happening, there are a few scouts that are pushing it to the right channel. And that brings us to the Model's Diary to unveil the OM Model Management photo shoot that we took place at the Oba Elegation Private Beach here in Lekki.
My name is Dalapoe Funuga. I'm with OM Model Management. My statistics are 34, 26, and 38. I'm about to do my makeup for the photo shoot.
Christine Aradubo. My statistics are 34, 27, 37. So when she told me she was doing this, I said to her, like, oh, just jokingly one day, I said to her, oh, what, I hope you're going to recruit me to be one of your models. And she's like, okay, fine, when the time comes. And she called on me during the week, and I'm here. I'm doing it as a friend for my friend.
It was really, really interesting, and at the same time, very, very scary, in the sense that the scary part of it, the water, there was a very, very strong current from the water. It was really, really scary, and I was really, really scared, but it's part of the business. It's part of what we do. We take risks sometimes and have fun.
Okay, my name is Irene Mwane, and I decided to join web management because I want to build my modeling career. I want to become a professional and international model. And I believe that with this agency, I'm going to get there. So far, so good. The photoshoot has been very wonderful. I did a shot with the trees, and it was really nice, it was interesting. And then the scary part was when I had to go close to the water. It was really scary, but I had fun all the same. It was good.
Hi, my name is Yvonne. I work with OM Management, and it's actually fun to work with the ex most beautiful girl in Nigeria. Terrible and transparent, and also professional. So yeah, OM Management is like the best agency so far. And like, I see the pictures, they're going to come out really nice.
Hi, my name is Amma Cecilia Bisson, CEO of OM Management.
Oh my God, it has always been my dream to have an agency of myself, and coming from a modeling background and beauty, and being an ex-beauty queen, it's just fantastic. I've always dreamt of having like a very professional and standard agency in Nigeria. So after years of modeling in New York and winning Most Beautiful Girl in Nigeria in 2003, I just felt it was about time to get it all started, and I'm very excited. I feel we have a lot of potentials in Nigeria, a lot of girls that you can export out there. It's not about our girls just going to live outside the country to be able to model, but being able to stay in Nigeria and get booked outside the country, go out and come back, just like any other model outside the world would do. So it's very exciting. It's always been something I always wanted to do, and I'm very glad that I have started it.
Hello, fashion lovers. It's so sad I've come to the end of today's edition. So we'll come away again, same time, same station. And do remember on Fashionista, we'll always keep it in the form of what you should know and what you shouldn't know. Bye for now.
You're watching.
You're watching.
You're watching.
You're watching.
Fashionista.